Of the tens of thousands of tractors on farms across New Zealand, none are quite like this one behind me. This all-electric, self-driving model is the first of its kind to be imported here. And as our Queenstown-based reporter Jared McCulloch explains, it's hoped it'll help the drive to decarbonise our agriculture sector.
In chilly Cromwell, it's green for go. This new tractor powered by electricity.
This is like literally the final piece of the puzzle for our fully electric orchard.
Yes, sir.
The machine's been partly paid for through a government innovation fund. Central Otago's the first place outside of California to have one after 2 years and multiple trips to the States.
It took some convincing for us at Monarch to send one tractor all the way to the Southern Hemisphere. We see the potential in the market to be basically an example or showcase for the world on what is possible for sustainable farming.
We've been running everything without fossil fuels for probably 18 months now.
With agriculture representing 10% of all fuel use here, that sustainability is integral to the industry's future.
As overseas customers are beginning to ask questions now of their entire supply chain, if we don't do it, customers will be going elsewhere.
We're running this tractor with the solar panels that we charge it with for around about $2 an hour. It could be up as high as $20 an hour to run a similar diesel tractor.
One of these would set you back around $140,000. The battery lasts about 8 hours, but you'll be too busy doing other things because as it drives itself, I'm just here for the ride.
At the moment, we're just trying to train it to drive up and down our rows and get used to running on our orchard.
Why would you have shadow mode?
So you don't have to get in and out of your tractor every time you open a gate.
And what happens if we just stop?
It'll stop behind us.
Are you sure?
Absolutely.
That's still scary.
Workers are still required, however.
They will be able to handle all the tasks that this tractor can't do, like pruning, for example. You know, there are certain things that are always going to require a human.
Operating this tractor, though, might not be one of them. Jared McCulloch, One News.